So first of all, I think it's very disappointing not to qualify for the World Cup. It would have been fantastic for the team to go. But also one has to be realistic about it. I mean, at the end of the day, only 2 out of the 10 associate countries qualified before this tournament. That was Ireland and Afghanistan. And then in this tournament, out of the other 10 teams and Scotland. So only 4 teams of the associate countries are going to the World Cup. So, you know, we have to be realistic because obviously it means once you lose your ODI status, you find that teams with ODI status don't really want to play against you. They tend to play against each other because then it becomes official ODIs. So obviously losing our ODI status, it's going to be hard for us to find a good opposition to play against. And that is the only way you're going to improve your cricket, is to play against better opposition. And also the other impact that it will have for our cricket, it becomes harder to find sponsors. So, yeah, I mean, it's definitely not the end of cricket in Kenya. We've got a very, very proud history. You know, we played in 5 previous World Cups. Kenya did play. In 2003, in South Africa, we made the semi-final of the World Cup. So there's a proud tradition of cricket in Kenya. And, you know, there's a love of the game under the Kenyan people for the game of cricket. So it's definitely not the end of the road. I think what will... And our team had 6 players over the age of 30, which I still believe we made the right selections for this tournament because you need that blend of experience. You know, a guy like Steve Ticolo, who was our player coach, has played over 100, to be exact, 134 in the ODIs. Thomas Odoya, who was our vice-captain, has played also 134 ODIs before this qualifying tournament. So you need that blend of experience. But I think Kenyan cricket at the moment, the team will be going through a transitional period. Those older players need to be replaced. And I think one of the most important things, obviously you need your cricket development at grassroots and at youth level to get the base of cricket bigger. But it's incredibly important that you don't forget development of your senior players. And I think it's absolutely essential that you identify the next 11 best players in your country, you know, and then you work with that team. And it makes sense to have that as an under-25 or a golf squad, emerging players. And you work with those players and you cover each position in your national team so you know exactly who your next 11 best players are. And that is what Kenya will have to do now. We'll have to identify our next best players, work with these players, gradually bring them into the senior team. And by the time you play the next World Cup, you've replaced, say, 5 or 6 of the older players with these younger players. And then you've got the other 6 players with the experience of a World Cup qualifier behind them. And then you've got, again, that blend of experience and youth. But this is a qualifying tournament for the T20s in Dubai. When the team returned, Robin Brown stepped down. He handed in his resignation and he stepped down. Same went for the captain at the time, was Collins. Collins Oboyo stepped down after that tournament. So both our coach and our captain stepped down and they were replaced by Steve Ticolo as a player coach. And Rakit Patel, who's 24 years old, became the new captain. 6 runs in 35 overs with one of our young players, Irfan Karim. He's only 21 years old, scored a fantastic 100. And Rakit Agar, who's 29, scored an 80-plus. So there were some really good performances. And I think Steve Ticolo did a fantastic job with the team. And there's definitely, you know, it's a good future that way.